Let's kick this off with our first segment. We're fortunate to have some thoughts from Judy Woodruff. Judy is the anchor and managing editor of PBS NewsHour. She's an award-winning journalist with a career spanning more than 40 years, including serving as White House correspondent for NBC News from 1977 to 1982. She served as anchor and senior correspondent for Inside Politics on CNN for 12 years. Previously, for 7 years, she anchored a monthly program for Bloomberg Television, Conversations with Judy Woodruff. She's received more than 25 honorary degrees and served in key roles for a number of civic and charitable initiatives.
Hello, everyone. I'm Judy Woodruff of the PBS NewsHour, and I want to thank the Committee of 70 for inviting me to participate in this year's event. I have a family connection to Philadelphia as my husband grew up there, so I'm especially honored to join you. I also want to congratulate you on the work you have done over the years to strengthen our democracy, and especially to congratulate your president, David Thornburgh, for his leadership as he prepares to step down. As I do so, I also want to say hello to his remarkable mother, Ginny, whom I've known for many years as an extraordinary advocate for those with disabilities. As a mother of a son with disabilities myself, I am so grateful for the work that Ginny and her late husband and David's father, former Attorney General Dick Thornburgh, did to further this cause. I've covered American politics for 50 years and Washington for more than 40 of those, but it's safe to say I have never seen it as divided as it is today. When my husband and I were first married, both of us news reporters, we sought out Democrats and Republicans to try to understand the issues of the day and what political forces were at work. I remember inviting members of Congress over for dinner from both parties, and hearing spirited debates about major legislation, from taxes to foreign policy. I listened and I asked questions as these elected representatives from across the country spoke energetically, sometimes with great passion, about why they believed what they did and why they thought the other argument was wrong. But it was always with respect for the other side, with a sense that the other party might be wrong on this, but they deserve to be heard, that this is the way democracy works. Today is different. Far fewer members of Congress moved to Washington, much less moved their families here. They spend a lot of time traveling back and forth to their districts or states. They have to raise more money than ever before to run for re-election, a full-time job in itself. And they spend much more time with members of their own party, caucus meetings and other party-only gatherings. Many hardly know anyone in the other party, much less become good friends with them. People who belong to the other party are too often viewed as not just wrong, but evil or unpatriotic. Disagreements over the right way forward on government spending become a shouting match over who's a loyal American and who isn't. I used to believe that this was a mainly Washington phenomenon, that the American people, most of them, wanted their members of Congress to work together to try to solve problems for the whole country. But now, helped along by the influence of the news media, highlighting opinion rather than reporting, and with that opinion spreading like wildfire, being welcomed by people already holding those views, and with so many members of Congress running in safely redrawn congressional districts, appealing all but exclusively to their own political base, I now see many Americans demanding their elected representative toe the line. Don't dare compromise, or I will vote you out, or even clinging to falsehoods to make their case. You asked me to project where the parties and the country go from here. It's clear to me that both parties are split in their own way. Progressives and moderates among the Democrats, and pro and anti-Trump factions among Republicans. They have a lot of sorting out to do, and healthy debate is good for our democracy, both within and between the two parties. But I believe perhaps the only way they're going to return to a more civil way of working with each other is if American voters demand it. Right now, the most active and motivated voters seem to expect this kind of partisan warfare. If we want anything different, the American people themselves are going to have to call for it. And if there's a role for the news media to play in this process, I'm eager to understand what that is. In the meantime, we in the press need to keep doing our best to report accurately and fairly on what's going on, and not contributing to the partisan warfare by promoting it or exaggerating it or giving it more attention than it deserves. We need to stick to reporting, explaining, and analyzing when we know enough to do that. Bottom line, we need to focus on shedding light and not heat. Thank you for giving me a chance to say a few words. I wish you the best with the rest of your program.